So, guys,
welcome back.
Hello.
Welcome.
As you may notice, we have a guest here today, and our guest name is
Pablo. I mean, if you want my last name, that's Vallejo.
And where is Pablo Vallejo from?
Mexico.
In Poland. And where do you live?
Yeah.
I live in Lublin, which is located in Poland.
Bardzo dobrze. How many languages do you speak?
That's a difficult question, but I would say that I can communicate in four languages.
Which languages?
So my native language, which is Spanish, English, which I've learned in school, Polish, and Swedish. Two countries I've lived in the past. Oh, well, I live in Poland now.
And now he's studying French and?
Italian. Yeah, I study French and Italian now.
So we see in 1 or 2 years, he will like...
I hope that in 1 or 2 years now I'll be able to manage these languages, this new one.
Well, now you know a little bit about Pablo.
Yes.
Welcome to With Love from Lublin.
Thank you for inviting me.
And Julia has a little something fun planned. So I'm not her.
Yeah, so we prepared for you really funny thing.
Mm-hmm.
So I prepared for you music.
Okay.
And we will try to dance together with you.
Mm-hmm.
And yes, I know you
dance. I know this.
For sure.
So you'll try to dance as much as you could good with this music because it will be like different music.
Okay.
And it will be like from different countries.
Mm-hmm.
So like feel free to show yourself.
And if you can guess the country,
yeah.
Bonus points.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay, I'll try to guess.
So you have 1 point for...
Well, maybe like you drink the coffee.
So
yeah.
Wait, I want
to... Like, great information,
guys.
Otherwise, no coffee.
Do I get a prize for guessing all the countries?
The coffee. You thought it was just, you know, there, but it's actually not.
Like, so 1 point for rain dancing, and 2 point for the country.
I'm gonna get 0 points.
Yeah. And if you get 0 points, then...
No,
I should,
no
also, I should also have a prize for 0 points. No one can manage to have to achieve no points, right?
Well, okay, why don't you guys put in the comments what Pablo would get for 0 points?
Yeah.
And then we'll figure it out and keep you guys updated.
So,
Wait, you're gonna dance with me? Not me alone, right? I don't wanna dance alone.
You see
the
lights?
They're both dancing.
Yeah.
Yeah, lights.
You see the lights? They're dancing around the room.
Yeah.
Yes. We're all dancing, right?
So I cannot dance because I'm switching music. So it's like really hard. But are you ready? So who will dance? You, for sure.
Pablo,
okay.
I dance.
I think we can all dance.
Yeah, we can like join in.
That way
you're not just having to like...
That way I'm not making a fool of myself alone.
No,
so,
you're not making a fool of yourself.
No, for sure. So I will switch music and dance a little bit with you, and you will try to dance because it will be a little bit different from different countries.
Okay.
We'll be back in 1 second.
Okay. So, the first song, we are back.
Disco!
I mean, I have to guess the country, right?
Yeah.
I mean, at the end of the song or now?
No, right now.
Right now. You have 30 seconds.
I don't know, United States?
America!
Woo!
But actually, it's not.
No.
Are you not American? Are they British?
Wait.
No, I'm thinking. Like
Bee Gees?
I think
they're
American. Earth, Wind, Fire.
Oh, it's Earth, Wind, Fire. This is
no.
I'm so
you see, mine is mine.
Where are they from? Germany?
I think a little bit Germany could be.
You're supposed to know.
No, I didn't. Oh, I should
know. They don't know.
But they were actually like taking some music for French movies. So
they use them in American movies too, like Madagascar.
Okay,
I got no idea. I should get that point since they showed the American
too, maybe? I can't remember that.
Okay, let's the next song.
Let's travel to a new
Yeah. Where we are moving.
Wow. This is new. Never heard this before. I would say this is somewhere in Asia, maybe? Am I close? I don't know. Can I guess two countries, maybe?
Okay.
South Korea or Japan?
Yes, Japan.
Japan!
Yay! Bye!
That is, like, cool.
Dancing? Yeah, I like it.
Yeah. Okay,
next
song. We are moving. I think you know it, like, come on.
If it's from my country,
I'll know.
Sorry!
If it's from my country, I'll know.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe. I hope if you put some, like, you play something from Mexico, I will guess it.
Which country?
Like, come on.
Terry Williams? I actually don't know where he's from. I know he's from North America, but I don't know if Canada or the United States. Or maybe he's from somewhere.
I think American.
Yeah.
Okay.
North America.
America! Yay! Okay. Okay. So that's it. Part of our interview, that's it. Maybe we'll be like just end of our videos. Yeah, you know. Okay, guys, you are good. Come
we actually
on.
Played this song on my first day of school, pep rally in high school.
Ooh!
1 year.
Wow,
my French exchange student thought that all American high school students did was party because of that.
Wait,
and I told her no, it's just the first day of school.
Okay.
I love you, Chloe. Je t'aime.
Okay. So we are moving. Just us.
Yes.
But not least.
Yes.
Okay. I'm ready. Okay. I know which language this is. Which is Spanish, but there are many countries who speak Spanish. I have to sing. I need to hear it again.
No,
I would say Puerto Rico, or yeah, I'll go with that one.
Puerto Rico.
Okay, I said it was like Spain.
I have no idea.
Can you hear the accent
from
the music?
Yeah, I think it's from the Caribbean, right, from the Caribbean island. Puerto Rico or... I have no other like, place in mind.
Alright.
So we're dancing!
It's cool music! Actually, I get married into this music.
Really?
Yeah, we can get married into this music.
You get married?
My first dance, like in the wedding. When I was 16, I was prince later, and it was like some training about what making event, and they were like need some break to like have like this event to see how we're doing like in real life. So they say it's an I'm the youngest. So probably the best person.
I don't know.
So yeah, I know the song. Actually, I'm not feeling. And last part.
Holly, what are you doing?
Checking my phone.
You put an event.
Done.
Yay! Okay.
Last question, Spanny.
Can he ask questions? You tell us.
In comments, but not today.
Yeah, I guess that wouldn't really work because we're filming the interview.
Yeah.
And you wouldn't tell us after this is done.
So maybe if he is good with answering one question,
okay.
We can like...
I'll try.
We'll see.
I don't know.
We'll see.
Alright. So tell us. You told us that you spoke a lot of different languages. How did you learn them? And what are, like how were you able to practice them, to learn them, and what advice do you have for people trying to learn maybe a language?
Okay.
If they're in Poland and they're struggling too.
I see. Well...
I'm struggling, too! Come on! I know Polish! But I'm struggling because I know Polish! Because here's so many people who are asking for money because they know Polish!
What?
For money?
Yeah,
they
are
all
money.
They want you to become their teacher.
No, they want money because they are, they have
the
Yeah.
I usually don't know when that's happening. I'm just like, przepraszam, nie mówię dobrego polsku.
I think I started to speak English. I'm sorry.
I gotta admit that I do the same, although I understand Polish. It's like, oh, sorry, and no Polish.
I don't speak Polish.
And now Chekhov is speaking.
Okay, so I think I'll answer the question now. I mentioned I speak some few languages, European mostly.
A few.
And I would like to learn more. The way I've learned the ones I already speak was through, well, mostly on my own. I use I don't know if this method that exists out there, but it's something I work on my own, which is a lot of listening, audio, like podcasts or audiobooks, which is something I love to do. Because you can do it as you do other things, you know, you go for a walk and you can put your headphones on and play something in the language you would like to learn. Even if you don't understand everything, at least a couple of words will come to your mind and will stay there if you make the effort to remember them.
Mm-hmm.
And that will be my second thing, try to remember things. Do not just listen and forget. I mean, there's nothing wrong with forgetting. I do forget a lot of stuff. Many times words and idioms and things like that, and then I need to be reminded of them. But try to remember. Try to write it down on your phone, on a notebook, or just put it in your mind and repeat it. Try to remember the few new words, the grammar construction you would like to practice. I think those are my two best tips. Like lots of listening and try remembering. The last tip is just talking to people. That's I think most of you. Will know that already. That's pretty obvious. Not in order to get better at something, you need to practice it, like playing an instrument. In order to get better at playing an instrument, you need to practice it and get down to it. So,
I feel like a 2-year-old in Poland. Dziwa, dziwa.
But it's actually, I will say that I know I was near you like last few days a lot. And I could say that you're listening a lot of things and you're giving it a lot of time even when you are in some program or studying. So like usually for a day, how much time you're giving for studying new languages?
So Polish has a special situation. I have a special situation because I live in Poland, so I can hear it all the time. But if I don't live in the country, for example, when I was learning English and I learned it in Mexico, what I would do is about at least an hour, but I've gotten to the point where I can actually go for 5 or 6 hours every day. But
that's
I don't have a lot of things to do besides my studies, and after studies I have free time. So if you can only give it 30 minutes a day, that's fine. It might take you a bit longer to get to the point where you want to get, but you will eventually get there, right? Maybe not in 6 months, but in a year. It all depends on what your priorities are. Maybe you have other things to do in your life, and you're gonna have as 6 hours as I do, but maybe you can have 30 minutes.
Yeah, and it's actually really depend on your motivation and your actually skills. Like if you know some other languages and you're studying before, probably your memory like have.
Absolutely, yeah. When you learn one language, you kind of not only your brain understands how to understand other languages, how to learn other languages, which is something I would recommend everyone to find the right method for themselves. For me, listening and remembering, as I mentioned, works the best. For some other people, it's not really that useful. They might find another method that works for them. So also try different things. Give yourself a month to do one thing, and if you don't see much progress, try one for another month, another thing. But be serious about it. You know, that's something, motivation is one thing, but seriousness and discipline is one another. Sometimes I lose my motivation, but I don't lose my discipline, and I go every day back to my studies in order to achieve a good level.
That's a really good point, making that difference between motivation and discipline, because I think sometimes we can get them mixed up somehow.
Yeah, and don't see.
Yeah, and that's so true that, like, you know, we are our habits in so many ways, and so by having that discipline and being aware of what our disciplines are is so smart.
But also you like it.
I mean, I really love it. It helps a lot that my passion, I found my passion in learning languages. And even, I will mention it, I would like to become a translator or an interpreter. Whoop, so whoop. So that's my dream.
So maybe hire Pablo.
Right.
Yeah.
I'm a poor student, that will help.
If you have some translations that you'd like here in Lublin, reach out to Pablo.
And not only in Lublin, like, you know,
Earl
Poland.
Yeah.
So yeah. So for me it works that I have that passion, but you may have not a passion for every language, just for one, focus on that one.
Mm-hmm. So, oh wait, you were going to ask a question.
I want to ask a question about Lublin and stuff like that.
Oh, I was going to ask how you ended up in Poland.
Oh yeah,
should I start that?
This week I've answered that question over like 20 times.
It's fine. It's fine. Please.
It's fine.
These people don't know you. They don't. But now they do. Alright. So, Pablo, like, thank you for sharing that about the languages. Really curious too, how did you, growing up in Mexico, end up in Poland? And how did you end up living in Sweden? And how did you get to the countries? Why did you go? Tell us your story.
You want the serious answer or the funny answer?
How much cover you want to get? Can you like make it funny, make it serious, make it cool, you know?
Okay, I'll try.
We're ambitious, you know?
Yeah.
Tell us.
So, I'll start by saying that ever since I was a child, I had a dream to go abroad. It didn't really matter where. It could have been anywhere. It could have been, you know,
Antarctica.
Yeah.
Actually, if you watch the last video, you will get why Holly mentioned.
I love Antarctica.
Part of your work.
My guilty pleasure is like looking up the people that live in Antarctica and seeing how they live.
Well, there were a few places I didn't have in mind. I have to be careful in how I phrase my sentences from now on. I gotta watch out. So, I wanted to travel abroad and study there, right? Which is what I'm doing now, and I'm very happy about it. And so, when I was about 18, I remember very well, I was still living in my own country, in Mexico. And I had the opportunity, because I was invited by some people to come to Sweden to take an exchange for a year. So that was a very great and miraculous thing, I could say, because I didn't have to pay for the exchange. I was going to study for 1 year in Sweden for free. It was like in a scholarship. I just needed to get there, right? I needed to pay. So I swam across the ocean.
Great story! Great, you'll get more coffee!
I think I'm more surprised that you're just alive. I'm just swimming across the ocean.
When you are such a good swimmer as I am, the ocean cannot defeat you. No,
you see?
Woohoo! Mad talent. Wow.
No, I flew by plane, obviously. I live in Sweden 1 year. There I met more people from other countries in Europe, because the good thing of living in Europe, from my own experience, is that it's very easy to get from one country to another. You know, living in Poland, you can meet people from, I don't know, from Germany, Sweden, Italy, France, Russia, Ukraine, even from outside of Europe, like myself, like yourself, right? So that's a pretty amazing thing.
I'm from Europe.
She's from Europe, that's why.
I'm European. Yeah.
Normal life.
And
it's okay, you'll get it, you know.
And while in Sweden, I realized I wanted to stay in this region of the world, which is Europe. It's very beautiful. I recommend anyone to visit any country in Europe. All of them are very beautiful. And all of them speak English. If you don't feel confident enough to speak Polish...
But you should speak Polish
if you
can. But you
speak Polish. Yeah, you should.
Notice how Julia looks at me because my Polish is so bad. Like,
no,
I'm feeling the shame.
I just thought about France.
That is true. The French will do know some English, but they definitely, to put it kindly, prefer to speak French.
They kindly insist, sometimes not so kindly,
that you speak in French, which is understandable. It's their country, and you know. Yeah.
Just to wrap this up very quickly, I was in Sweden, then I was in France for a couple of months. In France, I met a special lady in my life. I came to Poland because I wanted to be closer to her. Things didn't work out in the end, but I fell in love. Not with a person, but with a country. I fell in love with Poland. So to me, the last 3 years, which is how long I lived here, has been an amazing experience. I came here, if they say in Polish, przypadkowo, which means, you know, randomly. I didn't plan it. I wasn't expecting this. It just happened, and I'm very happy it happened. There were a couple of things that helped me in my way, like friends who would like kind of invite me to their houses in the beginning because I didn't have where to live, but I'm here now and I'm very happy I decided to stay.
We are happy that you are here and in our community.
You know, and like for sure Pablo is not here, like just a normal student who is like doing his best for getting degree, but also as we talked about it before, you are managing speaking
language exchange at the church.
So could you tell more about it?
Absolutely.
How it came to be? Sorry, do you plan it?
Absolutely. No, I didn't plan it. I was talking to a friend who is also from, I mean, she's half Polish, half Mexican. I was talking to her in English because there were people around who don't speak Spanish. So I wanted to be nice. And one of them eavesdropped us, and he's responsible for a couple of things happening in my university. And he said, you know, that idea about having a language exchange with other students is very good. He said, great, you should do it. I was like, me? No, I said that if there is such a meeting going on, if there's a club, I would like to join. Well, there's none, so you can start it. Okay. It took me a couple of weeks until I decided that, yes, I want to start it, because I received comments from other friends and people that they also dreamt of such a club. So I said, I'm going to take this under my wing, is sort of saying, but I want everyone to, you know, have a place where they can come, feel comfortable to practice the language they would like to learn. And since I'm very passionate about languages myself, I said this is a great opportunity to see if I actually can manage a group of people, because probably in the future I'm gonna be a teacher, for students who would like to learn either Spanish or other language. So I said, okay, this is a great opportunity.
And you know, also you can use after and then it like makes this idea more with finance, and it's like could be even about this cafe exchanging.
Yeah,
you can like make it like few things like in different countries. You know, it could be like big project.
Yeah,
and
you could
open like little coffee shops where you have stuff from like.
But also yeah, it's you know it's a great idea, and I think that everywhere there are many people they are moving, changing. And in Europe, it's like, come on.
Especially the major cities in Europe, it's just people move all the time.
Indeed.
Yeah.
So yeah, Like I'll future business.
Pablo's future.
Millionaire. Like, you see who we have here.
Maybe. If it happens, I wouldn't be mad.
There we have it.
So, and a small person for is, you know.
Yeah, just for
helping you. Yes.
We'll kindly take 99% of that.
Holy, I just agree.
We will do good things with it.
I don't think so, because when I came here, I was invited here and they promised me coffee, and I haven't received no coffee so far. So I don't know. That doesn't count.
That is a lie!
So
come on. You have coffee right here! That's a lie.
Lying.
It's okay, it's all good. Pablo will eventually have coffee.
Yeah, a little bit. Just a little.
Just a little bit, because it's caffeine.
Maybe.
Too much caffeine.
A little bit.
No.
That's like an American. I'll just have a little bit.
Please, a small caffeine just in the United States.
Yeah. Let me give you the biggest thing that we have.
Stop. We are in Europe.
Yes. So a small coffee should be this big.
Yes.
So that's what you get.
Yeah.
But I'm in the house of an American, so.
But this is in Poland.
In Lublin.
Okay. I'll be satisfied with anything.
No. He's great. Maybe we can give you like this.
Now he has his coffee. He's got
you see.
Confidence.
Confidence.
I'm not sorry. Really not sorry.
Let's go.
So, how does this coffee taste?
Pretty good. It's pretty good.
Do you get what you want?
Thank you.
Do you feel the caffeine? Like,
yeah.
Not yet, but in 5 minutes I'll start to feel it.
Okay. We're already scared.
So we need to end this video in 5 minutes. Yeah.
Yes, okay. Really quick question. We're also curious. So like we know that like you were not a Christian and then became a Christian. Like what, like in a really short story, like what did that mean to you, becoming a Christian, and how is that incorporated in your life now?
So I can tell you that, as Holly just mentioned, I wasn't a Christian. I was born in an atheist, you could say. I don't know if that's the right way of putting it, because I was born in a family without desire to meet God in their lives. So that was my childhood. No God, no church, no prayer, no nothing regarding religion. And even against religion sometimes. I remember my father telling me that religious people are not to be trusted, because if they believe in lies and fairy tales, as he called them, how can you trust such a person? How can you trust them with your stories, with your, you know, how can you become a friend of a religious person when they are living in another world? So that was my idea of religious until I was about 13. When I was 13, I met my first Christian friend, and he was a very nice person. One of the nicest I ever met in life. One of the nicest in my class, for sure. I struggle a lot to make friends, but with him, it was so much easier. I didn't have to pretend I was someone I was not. I didn't have to pretend I liked things that I didn't like. He understood who I was, and he cared for the person I was. And that really attracted me, because no other child in my class treated me that way. And although I was only 13, I was in a great need of having, you know, some sort of love as anyone. And he showed me that love through his friendship. Later on, I found out that he is Christian and his family is also Christian. And a couple of times they invited me to their house. In their house, I started to understand a bit of what prayer is and who God is. Mm-hmm. Then he invited me for some sort of young people events that happen every so often, maybe twice a month, maybe every week. It depended on the amount of time these young people had. And I went there a couple of times because I was really curious to see if that was only my friend who was nice to me, or if all Christians are nice, like my
What's
friend
going on here? Yeah. I need to figure things out.
But it's great that you started to research, you know.
Yes.
Yeah.
I found out that it wasn't only my friend who was that lovely towards me. It was actually all the people whom I met in this church, in these meetings, in this club for young, for teenagers basically. We were about from 13 to 18 max. Oh. And everyone was so nice to me. And I really liked it. I think that was the first impression I had from real Christians, that they were not only nice, but honest about being nice. Because you can pretend to be nice, and you can feel when someone is not being nice, truthfully. But they were nice, and they were honest about it. If they didn't feel like saying, like pretending, they were okay with being maybe a bit like less happy that day, but that didn't stop them from being, you know, nice towards me. They never criticized me for my mistakes, which I did a lot of, like breaking things in the place because I was a bit clumsy, and yeah, that was really changed my perspective of religion. Even if they believe in lies, at least their way of living was good, right? And to me, that mattered more of what they believe. Because the way they behave was very, very impactful for my life. It took me a couple of years, about 4, to understand that God, faith, and all the things they talked to me about from the Bible and the stories of who Jesus is were not at all false. Actually, I found out that I started to believe in those things. And at the beginning, I was scared because I was like, oh, I'm getting my brain brainwashed, right? I was very scared. I was very scared until I realized also that believing in God was bringing me a lot of happiness and fulfilling the emptiness and void I had in my heart before. And that couldn't be, I mean, if something as amazing as that was happening in my life, that couldn't be a lie, right? It had to be true. It had to be true that there is someone who cares for me that much and who is so close to me that he wants to love me and fill my void. Mm-hmm. That I eventually declared that I believe in God. I got baptized at 17, 18 years old. I mean, it depends how you look at it, because I received my baptism at 17, but I guess I wasn't fully convinced until I was 18 that I believed in God. A couple of years traveling around the world, all of this happened in Mexico, but then I have experience living with Christians from other parts of the world, from other regions of the world, from Europe, from Africa, from Asia, from North America, South America, from every place in the world, and I realized that even if we speak different languages, even if we have different cultures, and we eat different stuff, and the way we live our lives looks a bit different, there's one thing that unified us, and that is our faith in God, and it makes it so that every connection I've had in the church with other Christians have deeply changed my life, and have deeply impacted and make me understand things I didn't understand before. So yeah, I'm very happy, and that's my story, right, with God. I'm still living that with God today, and I want to go further with my faith, and I hope to be one nice friend to someone who is in need. Mm-hmm.
Thank you
for
that.
Thank you. It's always beautiful to hear. Why is this so funny? Why are you guys laughing? The coffee? Do you want more coffee?
No, it's fine. It's fine.
Do you need more coffee?
The coffee
I'm drinking. But it's always so interesting to hear. Like we all have such different stories, and it's always cool to catch a glimpse into somebody's life story. So really, we thank you for sharing your story and for inspiring us to learn more languages and to To dance,
yeah.
To be able to communicate with more people, and also to take action where we see things are missing, like how you started like the language club, like something was missing, and you took that step and was able to bring people together and inspire them in their language learning in a place that you're passionate about. So it's really cool, and so we're all just really glad to be inspired by you today.
But also, I really, really appreciate to see you. For this, you know, you're a really open person, hold this different experience and to try new. I think it's for now really important skill to be open for new things and to be disciplined to achieve. Some things that we put for the first place, is it some skills or is it our beliefs? Like, there's a lot of different things, but it's really important to have this hierarchy of what we want to do, where we want to get, how we want to look like.
Yeah, I agree with you. I really like being open to new experiences. I don't always happen to be as open as I wish I was, But I do try my best to stay open to what life has for me. And I hope everyone of you to be open for what life has to offer you and God. If you doubt that he doesn't want to give you amazing things, well, I invite you to maybe just be a little bit more open.
Thank you.
Thank you, Pablo.
And we have our channel, and
we're gonna take your coffee now.
Sorry.
We ended our video, so we have no more coffee for you.
You know, I said Christians are nice. No, I kind of changed that.
So Luke, what the name of our channel is?
Do you know the name of our YouTube channel?
Yeah.
So you watched one video.
One. You see who's watching it?
I think it's called Conversations with Holly.
Really bad.
I am Julia.
She's Julia, and she's Holly.
Dzień dobry. Yes, hello.
okay, so
I'll give you a hint. It starts with love from
Ukraine. From Poland, actually.
Where are we?
I thought we were Ukraine. We're from Poland.
Yeah, but where are we?
Where are you? Okay.
So with love from
Poland.
Okay,
I'm ready.
You might get some more coffee.
Yeah, I'll get it right.
Okay.
With love from
Lublin. Yay! So we gotta make hearts. Easy, it's a small heart. Yeah.
Okay.
Yay! And 1, 2, 3.
With love from Lublin.
So guys, thank you so much. Goodbye.